founder and CEO of Prince Cam Media Limited and Talanta Institute, an award-winning music video and TV producer, media entrepreneur, and philanthropist. Mr. Paul Mukoma. Karibu sana. I hope I've captured everything.
Asante. You have, right? But it's not about the scene. To the glory of God. Mwana Isho is about God's glory. So
yes.
We give glory to God.
Amen.
In everything.
Mm.
Yes.
As much as we do that, we love honoring our guests as well.
Thank
so we
you.
Are really honored by your presence here. And I hope I've captured everything, Mr. Paul Mukoma.
Mm. Asante. Thank you. I'm honored to be here too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So I want us, because I know you have a great testimony, you have a great background. Also, before we get to what you're doing right now, yes, we want to know, maybe before all this title, there is a story behind behind where you came from. Yeah, you tried a number of businesses which failed.
Yes,
I'm made to understand that.
Yeah.
I want you to tell us more about that.
Yeah, my journey is long.
Journey, yeah.
My journey is a testimony.
Mm.
And this is a testimony that also encourages me. Because in life we go through ups and downs. So even me, when at times I'm down, I look back to my story and go like, if God did this, you know, just like David, he said, if the God who was with me when I killed the bear and the lion, would help me kill this Goliath. So even me, at times when I face giants, I look back at this story.
Mm.
I grew up in the village. I'll tell it in brief.
Yes.
We don't have much time. I grew up in the village, deep in the village, and cleared my school. I wasn't sure what I wanted to be. But I really used to love cars, so I thought maybe at one point I'll be a mechanical engineer, because I really loved cars and I wanted to do that. But I didn't make it to university. After school, we had a small matatu, and I started doing business in the village. I am a tattoo.
Mm.
But the matatu was very old. It was grounded after 1 year. So then, my dad had finished all his the money he had.
Mm-hmm.
He had just retired, so all his pension money went with that matatu. So the only thing we were left with is a farm, a small farm we have in Naivasha, and I had to go and try if I can do something with this farm.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hard working. I went and tried everything. I was working for 10 hours a day. But still, I didn't get results there.
Yeah.
And I thought, I don't want to end up like everybody else here in the village.
Mm-hmm.
So I needed to come to Nairobi and look for greener pastures.
Mm-hmm.
So the only way escape was to look for a college. So I talked to my parents. My cousin had gone to a college and did food and beverage. And I told them I would want to follow my cousin's footsteps, because we were with him in school, go to the food and beverage company and get a job in a 5-star hotel, because he had already gotten a job in 1 year. I went to college. I wasn't lucky to get a job in a 5-star hotel. I got into a small restaurant in town here.
So what did you study at that time?
I studied food and beverage.
Okay.
I did food and beverage.
It's totally just opposite of what you're
doing
right
now. It's just a glorified name for a waiter, you know, learning how to be a waiter. You know, when you hear food and beverage, you might think it was just a certificate, 6 months certificate.
Mm.
It was food and beverage sales and service techniques. So you learn about food so that you can be able to serve people.
Mm.
I became a good waiter, got an internship in a restaurant, not earning anything. And then after that, I reapplied for the job there because I didn't want to go back to the village.
Mm.
And I also didn't want to tarmac so much. So I reapplied for a job after internship, and I got the job. I was earning 3,000 bob.
What?
But most of the time I could lose bills and all that, so it's deducted. So you make about 2,500 in a month.
Mm-hmm.
So after I worked a bit in the restaurant, again I also thought, is this it for my life? I looked at my supervisors and I imagined how long it would take me to become a supervisor or a manager in the hotel. And I looked at what they were earning. I was like, no, still this is not my dream. So, but at that time, I got born again. And that's why I love this show. It's about God.
Mm-hmm.
So when I discovered God and praying and believing, we were really challenged. And we used to go for keshas and praying and fasting and believing God to know our calling and to know our destiny. So as we were praying, one time we were praying in a kesha, and God directed me to resign from the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the only source of my income. This is the only thing I'm doing in Nairobi. And I'm scared to go back to the village. And I'm scared to tarmac. Mm-hmm. But what I was so afraid about came to me after resigning. I thought I'll get a job now in a five-star hotel. You know, you have faith as a Christian. You know, you must be elevated to a five-star hotel. And I had done some interviews at Panafric, at Windsor. Mm-hmm. So I thought I'll get a job in a five-star hotel, which I didn't. So I hammered. I went without food in Nairobi.
Okay.
At that time, my parents in the village don't know because I couldn't tell them.
So
they would tell
story,
me, just come back.
This is a story for so many people, for so many young ones, even right now, who are on the verge of even giving up.
Giving up,
yes, there are those even who are committing suicide. Because
very
true. Because there is hakuna mbele, hakuna
nyuma.
Nothing. Yeah. Maybe you can just encourage them.
Let me tell you, I went without food for days. At times I tried even hawking around globe, roundabout. There was a Maasai market there. I had some curios I was given. So the time we didn't have food, and the 200 I got from there is what we used for food.
Mm.
So long story short, later I worked in another restaurant for 2 months. I was fired.
What?
And after being fired is when I met my mentor, Juguna, who started training me in photography. We actually met when I was going for an interview.
Mm-hmm.
He was my former lecturer in college, and now he was doing photography on the side.
Mm-hmm.
So he told me, why don't you come, we try photography for the time being, as you look for a job.
And this one brings me to the next question, because I wanted to know, how did you get into the media industry doing such great success story?
Yeah.
Because there are a lot of success stories, including that song that just finished playing, DJ Nixi Ile Nyalkonacha Dhar Masimasika,
Mwema.
Yes, how did you get into that space?
Through Mr. Juguna, and I honor him so much because I would say it was divine, because at that time we were really praying and believing God. And at that time, it was also beginning of the year when people pray and fast. It's never in vain, I'm telling you.
Wow.
So I met Juguna at the stairs. He was going up. I was coming down very disappointed because I didn't make it for the job.
Mm-hmm.
And I told him, I'm tamaking, looking for a job. And he was like, why don't you come? He was looking for an assistant. Just come, we try photography for the time being. And I didn't have an option, so I was like, okay, let's do it. That same day we started.
Mm-hmm.
And he you know, that's how I learned photography. I learned how to do videos. And that time I was serving in the church. Those days I was serving in the church with Bishop Mwiro.
Mm.
We started working on the Kunanuru Gizani TV program.
What?
And when you were doing
what?
The Kuna, you know, when you were saying Songi ya Masimasika ni TBT.
I
was wondering,
sato
kisama kuna dawa. What will you say?
Kuna dawa,
also,
yes.
Kuna dawa.
Not really behind. I worked on it. I did the video, the video project.
What?
I worked on
projects like TBTs.
That TBTs is late Angela Chibalonza. I worked with Jimmy Gate when he was starting.
What?
I worked with Sarah Kay those days when you know, I was working at a church, and so many other musicians at that time, and later now people like Eunice Njeri, people like Emmy Kosgei from the time she was starting.
Yes, you remember.
I did four albums for her, and
what?
You can imagine each album was 8 songs. You can imagine how many those are, like, you know, 30, eight songs, yeah.
Mm.
So we, you know, that was my journey. So me meeting Juguna was such a destiny. A big breakthrough.
Yes.
And now me learning that and later starting now Prince Car Media.
Mm-hmm.
And going to where...
I wanted to know before, let me just cut you short. I wanted to know, these songs you did while you had started, you already started Prince Camp.
Yeah.
The songs like Masimasika, Emi Koskei, you are doing it with Prince Camp Media.
With Prince Camp Media,
Wow. Yeah. So later on then, can you tell
actually how Prince Camp came about. My nickname then was Prince.
Oh.
Because when we were being preached to and I learned our God is a king and we are the sons. So I started calling myself Prince and it became my nickname.
Uh-huh.
And I always had my camera, so it was just Prince and his camera. That's how Prince Cam was coined to become a company.
Mm.
So when I was doing this music, I became very busy all of a sudden. We had an office at Anniversary Towers at the lower basement. And so I started getting interns from, you know, people could see my name on TV.
No.
So they could come looking for internship from universities and colleges. And when they came in, they could do the job, and then I'm wondering, what did they learn in school? Because I needed to retrain them afresh, you know. It's like I'm training them from the scratch.
Okay.
And then I imagine I haven't gone to any media school. What do they learn?
You were training, but you had not.
I had not gone for any formal training in media.
Mm.
So I thought one day I would want to start a media school that really focuses more on practical, hands-on skills. And that is how the dream for starting Talanta Institute came about.
Okay.
And we, over the years, we have trained so many amazing producers, people like producers like Sammy D, producers like Steve Hunter. Steve Hunter produced the Moema video.
No.
Still in, when we were with him in my company. People like WB, there's so many producers who are doing great music videos today. And great TV shows, and some running TV media houses. And they
That's all amazing.
Came through Talanta Institute and Prince Cam Media training.
Well, that's a very those are successful stories that we're getting from you. And also, I meant to learn that you also nurture talents as well.
Yes, we nurture talents in different areas, both filmmakers. Guys, you see doing online stuff, we teach digital marketing, we train music producers, we train people who are now producing amazing music, and also talents in performing arts, people who are, you know, who act in TV shows and all that. So our main business actually, I believe our core business is nurturing talents.
But someone can come, a young one, a young person just comes to you, he has passion, no talent. Another one can come with talent, no passion. How do you handle such people?
For me, I believe everybody is talented. It's only that you have to discover your area. Because many a time when you think about talent, we just think of singing, dancing, photography, and all that. But did you know even people who are behind the scenes of such a program, people who, you know, who do so many other things, even there are so many talented people who work in offices. But their talent is just there, receiving people and talking to people. So I wouldn't say there is anyone who is not talented. Only that there are people who may think they are talented in music, and they are not talented in that. So they just need to discover their line and their lane and stick to that. But I believe everybody is talented. So when we meet people, because we meet so many people, they like there are people who came to my company thinking they are musicians. They ended up being producers. Like when Sammy D came, but Sammy D is also a talented musician. But he discovered a bigger gift in production. Right now he's among the leading producers in the region. So there are so many other people who came thinking, me, I'm a, like one time we had a driver and he was driving our van for years. One day I gave him a camera. I told him to try to take pictures. I look at him and this guy is creative. He used to look at pictures and I gave him a camera. Try to take pictures. Today, Johnny is one of the most amazing photographers. He has a company. He has a family. But when he came in, he just thought, me, I'm just here to drive. He had done a different course. But today he's among the leading photographers in the country. So we're also in that area where we can discover talent and also guide talent that is also misplaced. And we can tell you, I think you're better in this. Maybe you came thinking you're a good TV host. There's one guy who came and he wanted to become a TV host.
Not
to talk against him. He could be watching. But then he couldn't, right? I mean, he but then he discovered he was actually better in editing videos.
Wow.
Most of the videos you have seen today, big gospel music videos, both for Size 8, he's the one who's edited. When you see so many videos that came, Sammy D did, he's actually the one who edited those videos. But he came thinking he's a TV host. But we're able to direct his passion to the right place. So everybody is talented. You only need to know your area of talent.
Somebody is watching you right now and is very interested in whatever you're saying. And they're wondering, how do they reach you and how do they connect with you?
Yeah, how to connect is on... you can use Facebook.
Yes, your Facebook page.
You can use the Facebook page.
Yeah.
And they can reach us there. They, you know, later we can give them, I don't know if it's allowed to give a number, but Facebook can be one of the platforms.
What is the name of the page?
The page is Talanta Institute and also Paul Mukoma. They can find me there. We're also on IG and other platforms, but you can reach us on those two main platforms.
So Facebook and Instagram,
Talanta Institute,
and Paul Mukoma. everywhere. Yes. So if you really are interested in nurturing your talent, just follow him on Instagram and Facebook. Na utakuwa baraka sana. Guys, thank you so much, Paul. I know we can talk about a lot, a lot. That was Imaliza hii conversation. Yes, there's a lot to talk about, but because of time, we shall leave it at that. If we invite you again, we'll come back again.
Oh, yes.
Amazing.
I'm always happy to mentor and just encourage people.
Encourage,
because I was
on
the verge of giving up, and it's somebody who encouraged me. And that's where I'm where I am. That's why, as we speak to people like this, someone can, this word can change somebody who was about to give up or even commit suicide.
Amen.
And this can change their direction.
Amen.
So any other time, I'll be willing to come and inspire and motivate.
Thank you so much, Paul Nkoma.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Please reach him on his Facebook and